good evening, folks, and I hope I don't disappoint the purists amongst us. Do my best not to. What this is, you probably all know what it is. It's the Spirit of St. Louis NX211 Flight Case Stereo CD Radio, branded as Spirit of St. Louis, or Louis, depending on how you say it. Anyway, I don't know how they got around selling these things, because with the Spirit of St. Louis name on it, or Louis, however you want to say it, because anyone who knows their history will know that the Spirit of St. Louis didn't have an aeroplane on board. Didn't have a radio on board, because Charles Lindbergh decided they didn't want one, because it would save weight, and where he could carry a big heavy radio, because radios were big and heavy in 1927. You know, he decided that he could occupy that space with more fuel to aid his trip. He had more fuel. It was more like a fuel tanker than an aeroplane. Anyway, needless to say, no detriment to him, he got the job done. But the Spirit of St. Louis aircraft didn't have a radio in it. He was offered one and declined, as I say. Anyway, there's a bit of a correction on history. This actually, dare I say, does work. It's missing its aerial. It's a bit ropey, needs a good clean. The CD player seems to work. The radio works. The bulb is out in this side. The volume control is a bit scratchy. This power button here, a bit of a flash there from the smoother being charged up. You press it in, doesn't always stay on, so we need to look into that. It's probably just a standard PC switch. We'll look into that and sort that out. And I thought, just before I have my tea, you know, we might get into this and have a look at it, and then perhaps put the speakers out of the way, and then perhaps maybe later on even have a listen to it. I even plugged my what do you call it into it. See, the speakers detached, they're nice, you know. Well, they're not nice in the usual way, but it's nice that they've detached from the actual rest of the unit. Now, I presume you don't have to take these hinges all out off, although one of them has got a bit of damage, so we'll try and do something about that. But I presume that you have to take these screws out. We'll soon find out. Because they look a bit small and a bit shallow. It don't matter, they can go back in. Wonder if this comes apart in modules. I mean, it's by no, just check the back, make sure there's not a shitload of screws. I've just worked out how it comes apart, let's put them back in. They're just for decoration. And I don't think I have a screwdriver long enough to get into the back of this. Put these back in. I don't think I have a screwdriver long enough to get into the back of this. I should have, but I don't think so. We'll find out. I have got a big long screwdriver, but I'm not sure where it is. I mean, you really need a deep screwdriver to get into the back of that. I mean, it's really deep. This is going to take some fucking doing. See, I've got a fucking, I have got a long screwdriver, but it's where it is, it's another matter. Got one there, but it's the wrong type. Let's have another look in here, see if I shoved it to the back somewhere. No, I didn't. I've got this one, I don't think that one will fit it. No, it's too thick. Yeah, you can't get it on the screws. You can see the screw heads actually. That's the right length, but it's too thick. That ain't gonna fucking do it. Never in a million years, about that much too short. Close to there. I mean, right. I have got one, I just don't know where it is. Try and find it in a minute. See, that one fits, but it might be too fucking small. Yeah, it's too small, I can't get a grip. Fuck's sake. I thought I had one in here. I have got a fucking big long one, it's like... Oh, hang on, I think I know where it is. Bear with me. Right, we're back. There we go. Told you I had one. I knew it was somewhere. It was in the digital jukebox in the hallway. Yeah. Right. I bet when I undo this, I'm gonna find out it's made in China. Right. So we'll start by trying to get the screws out. This screwdriver usually fits everything. Fit them. That's unusual. Oh yeah, fits that one. I'll light it down, it might be easier. Let's pull the power cord out. It's not plugged in, but might be easier. I mean, I don't know what I'm going to do with this. I'd be Ferguson. Cassette deck that running through it earlier. That one I refurbished the other day and repaired. That screw's decided it wants to stay in there. Oh well, leave it in there. Just that top one there I couldn't get. I hope nobody's tried getting this and stripped the head off that screw. The battery terminals in this are nice and clean. It's obviously never seen batteries, because it can run on batteries, this as well. Not that you'd want to, because it probably cost a fortune. Because it takes what? 8 batteries. This is the one that's going to give us trouble, isn't it? Yeah, someone stripped the fucking head off this fucking screw. Well, I've got it though. Yeah, somebody's had a go at this one by the look of it. Couldn't get it out. But I've got it. There we go. Alright. One out of there missing. One out of there missing. So somebody's tried to get into it. Luckily for me, they failed. And this next one. Cover back on. We don't lose it. Let's move your phone, and we won't. We need it. I think I should undo this little screw here for the inputs. I might not need to, but I will. If they drop inside, it's no great deal. I could fit it back though. They obviously might have provided enough wire to refit it from the inside. Now it's just the. See if we can get this thing apart. Exactly just how that's accomplished, I don't know. Surely that'll take all this off. Surely you don't have to take all this off. Just see if I can. No, it just pulls apart. It just pulls apart. But probably with great difficulty. Let's start at the bottom. Quick. Something's loose in there. So I've undone something. I mean. This is ridiculous. I mean, I've done that. You now expect the thing to come apart, but that's stupid. Anything I missed? No, I've got all the screws. There's two down there that were missing. Let's just check they are missing. Pretty sure there was nothing down there. Yeah, there's two screws missing. Nothing hidden behind that, no. So basically, obviously you have to take all this off because this rubber's part of this. So I'm hoping I'm going to be able to get this tool in. You fucking do, you have to take all that fucking lot off, I'm sure of it. What a pain in the ass. No, you shouldn't have to take all that off. Do they go right down into the... Yeah, they do. Oh! I've just broken the hinge. Mine, it was broke anyway, so I need to glue that back together. But... broke anyway, I've just fucking helped it a bit more. Mind, get the epoxy on that later. Sort that out. Because there's a couple of other parts that need to be done anyway. But yeah, you've got to take all this out to get into the fucking thing. I'll come back. Right, well, we're in it. Took some doing, but we're in it. And no, I didn't wreck it to get into it. This rubber seal's come off here, but that I've just pushed back on. No problem, that. There we go. They didn't want anybody going in this, that's for sure. Probably to see how cheaply it was fucking made. To be honest, folks, it is. It's really cheaply made. I mean, there's nothing in here. There's not really anything in here that's of sort of, you know, that really stands out, jumps up out at me and says, yeah, that's done brilliantly. I mean, this is you, if I can get you up a bit. I mean it as far as I need to get into it to change that bulb, which is probably only a fucking LED, but I'm going to put LEDs in it anyway. Whoops, wrong direction. So this tripod, this radio control tripod's brilliant. Now if we zoom in a bit, we're going to get me tea in a minute, but we'll just have a quick look now. Right. Zoom in. Just, my tripod sloped. Oops. That needs tightening. There we go, now we're straight. Sorry about the jerkiness there. Right. Let's just get you. Whoops. Be nice if it had variable speed. There we go, that's perfect. Right. Start from the bottom and work our way up. Right, that at the bottom there is the excuse for a CD player. Although it is actually accessible to get in and clean the laser, which I'll do. Although the CD player does work. And if we go further, that's the control board for the CD player there. We go up a bit. I said up. And that's your amplifier. That'll be amplifier and there'll be some regulation going on because there's a regulator there. There's presumed left and separate left and right audio amps in this, so there's two mono amps in it. There's an audio chip over this side, another one over this side. So it's got two mono audio amps in it, which is actually not that bad because most of them usually only have one chip to do both channels. But obviously, power supply is in there, bridge recce and stuff. In there, and this is your left and right audio here. Don't know which one. I'd say this one's left and that one's right. Your speakers all go onto a terminal down there. They're soldered on, so I'm not unplugging them. And up here we have our radio. Yeah, a single chip radio, folks. How about that? A single chip radio with a shit tuner in it. And we have the volume control and the radio control, which are these dials up here, or at least the one for the radio is just a piece of string wrapped round it. But yeah, the quality's not brilliant, you know. But there again, with this shit, you don't expect it to be, do you? You know. But yeah, with all said and done, I'd have to say the quality's not brilliant. To be honest, I think it's shit for the prices that these things were being sold for. I've just cleaned the laser. It was working anyway, so just get a wipe there off camera. Anyway, so there's your radio. While we're here, we'll spray the volume control because the volume control does need it. And luckily we can get into this one. We can get into this. Just. Squirt. And a double volume control on this. Yeah, it is. Let's put my glasses on. I can't see the other fucking side. But yeah, it's a double gang volume control, and when you spray the stuff in there, that goes into one side and there should be a hole on the other fucking. No, the holes are both in the same place. So what we'll do, we'll try and get some in. There we go. Do it that way. There we are. that's the switch clean. Just rotate it a couple of times. There we go. But it's got two speakers in the side of this, which are for your, what's the control say, bass boost. It needs it and all, because when this thing's running, there's hardly any bass at all on it. You turn that bass boost on, it does make the sound a bit palatable, a bit more listenable. But there's not really a lot I can tell you about it, apart from the fact that you know, when you unplug things on it, like most other shit you get these days, the plug tends to come off. With, oh, I'll leave them off for a minute because I want to look at replacing those two bulbs. Don't even know where they're soldered on. They go out through the front there, and a bit of shit's just dropped through it. And if, the job for after tea is to just sort them two bulbs out. I don't even know where them bulbs get their power from. Well, they've got to get it from the main power supply, haven't they? It's got to be the case, hasn't it? But where... Yeah, they're soldered into the radio because there's no wires going anywhere else. The only wire you've got is this here, which is a signal wire that takes a signal from the radio to the amplifier. And... you know, but that's pretty much all she wrote on it, really. There's not really a lot to fucking tell you. Well, these are your bass boost speakers here. It says there, bass boost speaker, so that'll be the left side, and bass boost speaker for the other side. Yeah, but that's your... That's your FM aerial. I need to look at the FM aerial because it's broke. It's down here. Don't know whether I'll be able to do anything about it. Oh yeah, it screws out. Yeah, it's on a captive screw, that, by the look of it. I don't think I've got an aerial that'll fit this. Well, I say it's on a fucking captive screw. Screw back down again. You get a piece of board here that slides out, it's probably glued in and all. But yeah, there's the aerial. There's the screw for it. You have to go in with a really deep screwdriver. You have to get a really deep screw. The screwdriver doesn't stick to the fucking magnet. I don't know who made these things, but to be honest with you, for the money they were asking for it, now, where's the wire connected to? Can I pull the aerial out down that way? Yeah, we get our aerial out that way. And it's just connected on the bottom there, so if I undo that screw there we go, make sure I don't lose that, leave it with it. So it fell out anyway, that's the end of that screw. Right, well, the aerial's fucked. I'll have a look in my stock and see if I've got a replacement aerial for it. But you're all saying it ain't worth it, Andy, throw it in the bin. Yeah, maybe should do, but no. I reckon once it's polished up, I'll find somebody that needs it more than I do. I might even do a Bluetooth mod on it. Anyway, what we'll do, we'll call this part one. And in part two, we'll have a look about putting an aerial on it. Catch you later, folks. Hi, folks. We're here. We're back on the fake Spirit of St. Louis radio CD player. And basically, what some... Oh, try switching it on. There we are. And basically what some numhead had done during the manufacturing process, they'd glued the volume control from the potentiometer into the volume control on the front. Very clever that, wasn't it? You know, you have to hand it to them, don't you? And basically when I removed this board, I snapped the shaft off the control. And the other bit, the other half of the shaft, it's one of them slotted controls with the splines and the slot on it. If it hadn't been, it wouldn't have snapped. If it had been solid, it wouldn't have snapped, but it snapped. Anyway, so what I've done, I'll bring you in if I can. For a close up, you can probably already see it there. Right, what I've done to effect a repair, I've got a piece of cassette tape metal, which is the little mirrored piece behind the sponge, or that the sponge on more modern cassettes sits on. And what I've done, I took a sliver with the Dremel, cut a piece off, it's just the right thickness, and just super glued it. The super glue hasn't taken very well, but I've already test fitted this and it does work. And actually it works, because once the circuit board's screwed back in, it actually holds quite well. So what I want to do while we're here, and I don't know whether I've shown you my flexible straw made out of a piece of insulation from wire. You can get this exactly where you need it. So if I flick that down there, and I can get some when I put the straw back on the nozzle. There we go, and it's just a perfect fit. That. I've already cleaned the volume control. Right. What I want to do next, I want to have a look to see whether we've got DC to these bulbs or whether they're using AC, because one of these bulbs is fucked and I want to just change them both out if I can get them. If I can get them out, I want to change them both out. It doesn't look like I'm going to be able to, because they're glued in with, they appear to be glued in with hot snot. And can I get to them? I think we're going to find the answer to that out very soon. They're fucking well and truly glued them in, aren't they? Oh yeah, here we go. Well, there's the hot snot gone. You know, they glued them in with hot snot. Yeah, still can't get the fucker out. They come out through the front, I wonder. I know these panels here don't come off, they're just fucking, they're just moulding. They don't come off, they're just moulding, that's just part of the front. Wonder if I can get to it from, no, you can't get to it from behind either. It would have been nice. Oh, here we are. Managed to move the bulb. Well, they've got it in from the other way, so must be able to get them in that way. That's the way they've done them. It's the way the manufacturers have done it, so let's see if we can. Because I want to put LEDs in. I mean, some of you might say it's not in keeping with the radio, but then again, the radio isn't in keeping with the radio. It's just a matter of working out how to get these out. Oh, that's it. Just push them in. There we go. And the other one should just pop out. There we are. There we go. Make sure I get the plastic, the fake glass. And the bulb should be. I wonder if this does this pull out. Because I don't want to break it. Yeah, that pulls out. And look at that there, folks. A little tiny bulb. So what I want to do next, I want to just check I'll tell you what I'll do. These are bulbs are wired. I thought they were wired in series, they're not, they're wired in parallel. Now let me just plug this in because I want to see if the bulbs we should be all out without floating. It's not gonna hit anything, I wouldn't have thought. Right. Let's find the fucking power lead now. That ain't it. No, that's not it. That's the speaker lead. So where's the fucking power lead? Fucking here somewhere. Where's the fucking power lead? I had a fucking thing earlier. Where the fuck's that gone? It was there because I unplugged it. I think that could be it. No, that's not it. Oh, for fuck's sake. There's a power lead here. It ain't the one, but... No, it's not fucking... It's no good. There it is. Found it. So if I plug the power lead in, unplug the Dremel because we don't need that now. If I plug the power in, I can find out . Let's move this board so nothing shorts. There we go. We should be okay there. There we are. Let's have a look. None of the bulbs are working now. One of them was earlier. Yeah, one of them was earlier. Let's just see whether we're getting AC or DC to these bulbs. Because if not, I need to find a DC source to drive the LEDs. So, let's have a look. We're on. On. Now, let's have a look. 6.3. It's only showing 4 there. Get the other way around, it fucking shows 6. Six point three. Alright. I think my LEDs only work from 5 volts, 9 volts. Yep, 6.3. Right, so at least I know. So what I'll do now, I will lift that back up to there. Get it down. What I wanted to do was feed the wire for the bulb, but it won't fucking come up. There we go. Because now I can clip the bulb off. Now, let's. I mean, these LEDs might work at the voltage, but I don't know. But I haven't got any bulbs that small, that's for sure. So we'll clip that off there. We'll just put one on to try it. I'll tell you what, there's a pain in the ass doing this. So I just want to put one on to try it. So. I'm not sure which way around it goes, but if it doesn't work, I'll just flick it the other way. Make sure that radio board's out of the way. So what we'll do, we'll connect first one. Just connect it together just to see if it drives it. If it doesn't, I'll find somewhere else in the circuit. I mean, there's a red and black there going to the amp. And that'll be DC, so I can tap into that if I have to, but we'll see. Let's flick that on. Well, nothing. Let's try it the other way. Or is the light switched on? On. Try again. If they don't, I'll just have to figure something out. Because I don't want the lights on all the time. Well, there we are. There we go. It does work. It does work. See, I'm not bothered about what colour they fucking shine up. I mean, fucking bother me that. I'll zoom out a bit so we can all see what I'm doing. I know it's a bit from my normal departure, fucking about with something so modern, but I was given this, and you know me, folks. Anyone who knows me knows I won't look a gift horse in the mouth. I will make sure. So even if I don't use this, it won't get wasted. I'll find somebody for it, you know. But I've got a feeling I will, actually, because, you know, I might have to make that all a bit bigger. Yeah, might have to make a modification there, because I'm not going to get that in. Move that radio board, there we go. Yeah, I'm not going to get that in there. No. So let's make a modification. What we do? There we go. Clean the. When you melt plastic with your iron, always clean your iron afterwards. And the other good tip is to make sure that you've got some solder tinned on your iron. And that way, when it melts into the plastic, might have to do a bit more actually. I don't think this is going to be enough. We only have to get the, whoops. We only have to get the two wires through. I mean, once they're through, that'll be all right, but that's obviously not far enough. I need to need the hole a bit bigger. But if you're using your iron like this, make sure you, there we go. Are you sure? I nearly forgot again. Doesn't that, when you've got a dobbing great screw in your iron and it gets hung up on the, there we go. Always make sure there's always something on your iron when you melt plastic. It's easier to clean your iron. Alright, let's just clean the excess plastic away. I've just melted. Right, try and do it so I don't scratch the front too much. Just move that, there we go. Then bring that there. That's it. Lovely and clean. Feed the wire back through again. Because there's a resistor in this wire, so it's a bit thingy. Now if I just give that a jiggle, it should just, that should come through there now and fall into place. But it doesn't want to. Let's try it the other way around. Right. Just give it a tug on. Need a little bit more. And I've got a feeling it's needed up there, and I don't want to go there because I don't want to cut through the fucking dial string. There we go. That's as much as I'm fucking doing because I don't want to damage anything. So that's as much as I'm doing. But don't want to damage the dial stringer out. I want to put these in so they're neat. You know, so, you know, the, hopefully the front will never have to come back off this again once I've done it. That's why I've gone for LEDs, and I think that's perfect. That is absolutely bob on, that's on the money, that, folks. Now let's see if the rest of the fucking dial will go back together. Back there, see if this will clip back in. It should. Right, so that goes in there, that goes in there. It does, folks, that fits. It doesn't, it doesn't affect the control. Just give this a fake glass, it might be real glass actually. No, it's fake. It is fake, folks, don't worry about that, it's fake. But, alright, so what we do next, clip the, see, I'm clipping this in now because I know I don't have to take it back out, because I know that as So basically that should look alright. So you'll pull that down there tight a bit, pull it slightly taut. Now what I want to do, I want to see what it looks like when it's on. I can't remember which one went where, so just whip this round, make sure the radio board's out of the way. I think the red went to here. I mean, I could easily do a check with a meter, but I'd rather just do this. It doesn't work this way around, I know it's the other fucking way. I've got the other one to fit on the other side because the bulb doesn't work on that side either. And the beauty is it can be still switched on and off. That's the wrong way around. That's... That should be right. No? Oh, hang on. It could have been right a minute ago. I've still got to attend to the dodgy power switch. So let's see. See if that's the right way around. Nope. It's fucking working before. Get that fucking black wire off. That fucking circuit board. Now. Try that. Let's see what it looks like. Yeah, it casts a bit of a shadow, but hasn't come back on. Well, the power's gone off. I sort of certainly saw that power switch out. There we go. Yeah, that'll do. I'll give you a good look at it once it's done. So let me find another one of my LEDs. I bought a fucking load of them, so finding another one shouldn't be an issue. There we are. And they do work from 6 volts. So let's push the other lens out. First of all, let's just clip the wire. Push the trim of the lens out. I got 2 out last time and it just popped out, so it should just pop out now. And I've lost my finger made off my fucking tuner, off my volume control, but that's no problem. That's no problem, that's fell off, but that's no problem. We know we can fix that, so it's no problem there. When you cunt. The first one just popped out. Come on. The first one fucking popped out with no problem, but I don't want to force them because they're plastic. I mean, what isn't plastic in this fucking radio? So. There we go. There we go. Oops. Make sure I don't pull on any fucking wires. I don't want to put it together and find I've pulled the fucking wire off and I've taken the fucking thing apart. There we go. See, I'll clean this up as well. Tell you what, they didn't cut that fucking plastic very well, did they? I mean, well, actually, it's not the plastic, it's the stuff that's round. There we go. It's the stuff that's round it. I mean, the volume was controlled with glued in with that shit. Pull that out. Yeah, and that bulb's definitely blown. Absolutely. Right. So, the same trick with the soldering iron. Whoops. That one goes to there. Right. Feed that through. Let's see if we've got see if we've done enough. Yeah, we've got that one perfect the first time. Scratch the crap away. I don't want anything that interferes with the trim going back on, and that will. So we'll just like a bit of molten plastic there, it will affect, just stuck in the groove, that's all. Just clean that out. There we go. And they don't have to be glued in because they're fucking stiff enough as it is. Now all I need to do is find my wires to put them in, because I just dropped them. Fancy losing my finger off there. It's no problem that though, because right, so basically we want to take that behind the tuner, which is where the original one went, and behind the tuner and try and feed it through. And then it'll just go under there, out of the way. Right, so. Alright, so let's cut that down to there. Cut that down to there. Right, so red goes to the left, goes to there. Right, and these just join together. These just join together and solder to the points. Join the two blacks. Just make sure I get them Do you know they're a pain in the ass to do these? There we go, that's one done. There we go. And join the two reds. There we go, let's tin them up with a bit of solder, just clean the iron. Which I forgot to do before, and it's now a bit on the other side of disgusting, and just hope. Let's give that a clean. There, we've got it. There we go, let's tin these up. So red to the, actually fucking, it indicates plus and minus on the fucking board, sure it does. Right, take that one, them ones off. Sure it indicates plus and minus on the fucking board, there's some up there. No it doesn't. I mean, why would it? They're only bulbs, aren't they? So we're soldering the red on. Why do I get the feeling I wish I'd soldered the black on first? Them up out the way so that they're out the way of everything. Get that one out the way of that band switch. It can be tucked down there out the way because nothing's ever going to be fucking going near them. There we go, just try them, make sure they work, and I'll show you them working when I put it together. We got the power going through that. Yep, they're working. Let's put the dial back on. I'll give you a quick look. So they're working. So we'll stick the dial back on. Just clean around that LED, I forgot, didn't I? The thing won't sit back in. Push that back in. Just make sure. Sure. Yeah. That's working. Just stick these back in. Shouldn't give me a hard time going in, the other one, the first one didn't. Let's make sure that the dial turns, doesn't get hung up on that. That's it. Right. Give the inside of the Perspex window a clean. Right, that's all on the outside, that crap. Right, put that back into position. Oops. There we go. Let's give you a quick look like what it looks like on. See if we can turn the whole thing round. Give you a quick look. There we go. Turn it round. Right, that's as much as you can probably see. Right, there we go. They'll do. To be honest, I think they look fucking better than the originals. Yep. Let's have a look, see if I can do anything with this power button. I probably can't because I don't even know where the power button is. Oh, it's there. Oh, I probably can. Let me have a turn it round. The power button's a bit dicky. All I can do with the power button, really, though, is just spray some stuff into it if I can get it in. Just contact cleaner, really. Just see if I can somewhere that should find its way in. See if that's found its way in. Not right, and the problem is I can't get to the fucking power switch from the back. There's not really any holes in it. So try and get through the front, see if I can just direct my holes. That's about to have got some in. It never came through the back. Let's try that. Yeah, that's got it. Staying on now. Wonder if it's fucking loose on this board. Yeah, it is. Yeah. means taking that fucking board out. I'm not fucking doing that. Let's try and fucking eat it up from this side. There we go. Yeah. That'll do. So now all I need to do is sort out the volume control, make a new piece of plastic for that, a new piece of metal for that. Unless I can find a piece of that I have made before and I've just lost it. So we'll see if we find that. If I can't, I'll just make another one. But that's all that needs to be done now. We can, the aerial, I've just gone for a piece of wire coming out the top. Make sure that piece of metal isn't in here. There's a fucking screw in here. Right. I know that's out of the aerial, doesn't matter. Put this screw back in here. And that's my phone, obviously. This time of the morning it decides to send something, or something decides to receive, something. So let's put this screw back in here. And that's that fixed. Now, where's my little piece of metal gone? Problem is, I'm probably going to find it. I think I have, I think it's here. So I've got a piece of a bit of super glue on it. Yeah, that's the piece. I'll just clean out the hole. Right, let's get another bit of glue, if I can fucking find it. There it is. And all I do is just put a little bit of glue on this. It's simple. Pop that there for a second. And I'm left-handed and it's difficult doing things with your right hand. Where's that wire come from? I snapped a fucking coil wire off somewhere. I hope it's come from there. Pulled the fucking wire off here. I hope it's from around here somewhere. The fuck have I managed to knock that off? Well, I'm gonna sort that out in a minute. Plug the Dremel in and clean that fucking hole out. Make sure I haven't gone too far down. No, we're okay. Right. Put our See, all the glue does really is just hold it in place. mean, the glue will never bond it. There we go. Oops. Fuck's sake. Need to get it straight. There we are. Leave that like that for a minute. Let's work out where this fucking wire come from. It's a ground. Is that another one? No, I found the foot for that. It ain't. It's just glue. So it's ground. So which means I think it's ground. I think it come from here. Soon find out. No, it didn't come from there. Have to work out where that come from now. It can't come from too far because it only goes so far. I think it fucking come from here. Or let's find out if we've got a piece of wire. Nope. I think it comes from here. No. It comes from somewhere. Well, it might not have done. Might have just been fucking. I can't see why that would be just. Didn't come from there. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to review my video, because that'll tell me, because I zoomed in on all this and everything, so I'll review my video, folks, I'll be back. Right, I'm back on it, folks. I've just checked and these wires, I've backtracked on my video, they don't seem to have come from anywhere. I've checked the AM radio and it still works okay, so I'm just going to leave it. I think they were just tucked out the way, to be honest, because there's no solder on the end of them or anything, so not bared off or out, so I can't see anywhere where they've come from. And even looking at my video, double checked my video and, you know, looks okay, so what I need to do is rotate the tuning control back fully this way. Oops. That's it. Make sure the volume control's rotated fully this way. That's it. Make sure these are fully down. They are. There we go. And that's ready for that to be fitted back in. I like the LEDs. Hang on. And there's another one for Donald, another old Trumpy. I did one in Graham's van earlier, yesterday now, because we're now, what, the next day. This is like, I went to bed earlier, had a couple of hours because I was on the tired side. And I woke up about 4 o'clock this morning, so it's about 5 or 6 now. and had a bit of breakfast, a brew, and got back into working out how to do this. And we went to see a friend of mine called Duncan, who deals in jukeboxes and arcade machines and things. And I've not seen him for a lot of years. I used to do some, I did some repairs for him years ago for on some jukebox mechs, and I think I did a power supply or something for him. I did a few repairs for him years ago. When I was doing the jukeboxes, I'd not seen him for ages, so it was nice to actually catch up with an old friend and have a brew. And I got a number off him for another old friend, my mate Derek in Newcastle, or as I call him, YI Man. I've not heard from Derek for a long time, and it was nice to actually, I rang Derek as well and had a chat with Derek for a bit. And, yeah, just had a nice little chat for a bit while he was on his dinner hour. And yeah, not heard from Derek since about 2008. We lost contact, and I didn't know Duncan had his number. I just happened to ask him, "Have you got Derek's number?" And he gave it me, so I rang him. And yeah, that was it. I got to, I actually made a few friends out of doing the jukeboxes. Another friend of mine, Leon Reeder in London, he supplied me with a load of bits when I had my NSM 20th Century 21 that I bought from Graham years ago. I completely restored that, and it was a lovely machine. And I've got a Rockola coming in. I've done a deal. For a Rockola 4487, I think it is, or 478. Can't remember exactly. Mystique. And I won't be keeping it. I'll be moving that on. I spoke to my friend, like I just said. Spoke to my friend YI Man, and he's known as the Rockola Man in his parts. And most other parts as well. He loves Rockolas and Roamis and things. And anyway, I mentioned this Rockola, and he says, "Well, what do you want for it?" I said, "Well, I'll, you know, make me an offer," and explained it is faulty, but I will try and repair it before I sell it because I get more. And there's a load of spares with it as well, so. I'm sure whatever price I decide to settle on, Derek will think it's fair. He's a very fair guy, you know. He's a very honest and fair guy. So I've dealt with him in the past. Never ever had a problem. So I'm pretty sure that, I'll get the best price possible from him. Another guy commented, I can't remember who it was. You know, that I do a lot of work for the price that I charge, the prices that I charge for me stuff. Well, the way I look at it, you know, if I pay, say, £5 for a music centre. If I give £5, then I don't mind. So that needs to go down because FM's at the bottom. FM's at the top, but at the bottom on the selector. So I need to jiggle this into position. Let's put my glasses on. Would help, wouldn't it? Put the old giglets on. There we go. Anyway, the reason why I charge the prices I do is because You know, if I get a bargain, I don't mind passing it on. I really don't. You know, if I do well, then that's okay. You know, I don't mind passing on a bargain. But you know, I do put a profit margin in. Oh yeah, Graham weren't happy when I stunk his van out. He got his window down. He says, "Open your window, you dirty bastard! Fucking stinks." He says, "You stink." I says, "I know." It was the right laugh. There we go. Give this a jiggle so it sits in to the tuner. Come on, sit in, you bastard. There we go. We're sitting in there. We're on the volume. Yeah, we're in. So, let's give this a bit of a jiggle. It's just this waveband switch. No, the waveband switch isn't in. And that's why nothing else is marrying up. Because the waveband switch isn't in. As soon as that waveband switch clicks in, the rest will. Are we still on the volume? Yeah. Now, jiggle this a bit. Waveband switch appears to be in. Yep. Let's move that to the middle. There we go. Now, just a matter of lining this back up to rotate that tuner slightly, just to clip that in. Check the waveband switch is still in. That's the lights. Yep, waveband switch is in. Now this is the tricky bit. Just push that slightly there, there we go. Hold the middle of the board. And then, let's find your screws. Put my screws back in. Whoops. There we go. I had me, what do you call it, connected to this? As I said earlier, my tape deck that I refurbished the other day had that connected to it, and it actually sounded not bad. Me little Ferguson cassette deck had that connected to it, and it actually worked too bad, you know. So, and because there's an input, because it has an auxiliary in and out, you can actually connect the cassette deck up and record from it as well, which is always nice. No, that's level. Yep. Right. That volume control repair should last a lifetime. Because it's gone back in exactly as it should, and it's, you know, the piece of metal I've used is well strong enough. Because you're not going to swing on the volume control to turn it up and down. You're just going to turn it up and down normally. You know. But those wires, they don't go anywhere. Them tuner wires, they don't go anywhere. Just aerial wires, they don't go anywhere. They just connect to the, just connects the aerial to the tuner. But Right, before I put everything back together, let's just check it all. You might say it will sound a bit muffled because it's only on the, what do you call it, speaker, only on the sort of new bass speaker. The power switch now seems to work. Let's turn the volume up. Automatically comes on CD there. There we are. That's only the bass. Long wave. FM. Got some interference coming from somewhere. Right, that's the CD. Let's just check the CD player. Now we've got a disc. Is there one in this? No, there ain't. There was one knocking about somewhere. There's one. Just check the CD player. Open. Ooh. That sounded a bit rickety on its way out. Hey up. How come we're sticking? Oh, hang on. I know what it is. Some wires there, shift them out of the way. That was a bit worrying. There we are. It's whizzed up. 22.77. That only said there was four tracks on that earlier. Yeah, have I pulled the wrong disc out? Just see. I'm sure it said there was only fucking four tracks on that earlier. Mind. Twenty-two tracks on it. Let's just press play and just make sure it plays. To tighten these up. Yep. Take this disc out. Diana Ross Greatest Hits. That wasn't the disc I had in it earlier. One I had in it earlier weren't that, was something else. Right. All I've got to do now. Oh, almost forgot. Got to plug these auxiliary wires back on. Otherwise, I won't be able to connect now to the auxiliaries. One of them's a bit fucking dodgy because the fucking pins all came out. And left the fucking, pulled the fucking plug off with it. Yeah, could be a bit tricky getting this fucker back together. Here we go. Now. Because the fucking plug's glued together. How many wires are there? Three. Come on. It's very, very fucking tricky to get this back in. Because get the first one just on. You just get the first one in position, the others will follow. But it's fucking getting you. It's getting in the right position. It's only an auxiliary, but it's still going to go on. There we go. Just wiggle it in carefully. There we go. We're back on. On that one, next one won't be too difficult because the fucking socket stayed on and the plug came out like it's supposed to. At least, suppose one way we've got doing that, at least you know which way around it fucking goes. There we go. Right, make sure no wires dangle down onto the CD player, which they're not. That's gone in as it should. Light down on its back. What the fucking hell's in there? Something fucking in there. Nothing. Oops. There we go. Fly that flat. And then just make sure the wires are tucked in, and now, I won't screw it back together yet because I want to just check everything works okay. Just get one of the speakers, I only need one of them. Right, and the speakers actually do clip onto it. Right, so I mean, these things are a lot of money for what they actually are. Right, let's check the radio.
Then you never hear about it again, and you think, right. What happened? The cat, exactly. The horse went through some real, real bad time, and I always try and now, me and Danielle, try and just give her.
Put a bit of water over that one.
That's working.
To be cancer.
And what would you say to others thinking of following in your footsteps?
I'd say, put that down. I'd say it's a great family day out, even if your family drives you mad.
We're not athletes, we're cancer beaters. Join us at racetholife.org in partnership with Tesco. And did you check that you locked the door?
Turn the volume down. Volume goes down all the way now, I never used to. Clean the switch, that's okay. And my lights. Here we go. They look better than what the originals did, and they'll never need to be replaced. My power button now works. T- takes a while for them LEDs to die out, doesn't it? Look at that. Don't know why they had to have them flash, but comes on now, stays on. You can wiggle the switch all you want. Just a dry joint. What I want to do is tighten all these. I want to check because these grills vibrate, so I want to check all these screws on these grills. I might have to put some glue behind them or something. Do something. Put something behind them. I'll just check them. Make sure they're tight. Yeah. Try another screwdriver. That's, I'm not convinced with that one. Oh. Well, that's better. Oh, a bit more of a turn on there. More of a turn there. Right, so what I'll do now, I'll unplug the speaker because I need to repair. I took the hinge off for this side because I thought it had to come off, but it needed to come off to be repaired anyway. So that speaker there for a minute. Lay this thing flat. And I can put the, can squeeze it all back together, I hope. There we go. That's all back in. Screws have fell out. Yeah, they're all on the desk here. All the screws should be on the desk here, but whether they are is another matter. Yeah. I mean, I won't sell this, I'll keep this because, well, I just think it's, you know, I mean, yeah, I'm not going to say I think it's brilliant, I don't. I just think it's a nice piece, you know, just to have in the front room maybe, or maybe as a bedroom radio or something. But, you know, I mean, it's not brilliant. It's a single chip fucking radio. I mean, I've built better with kits. My daughter built a better one with a kit years ago when she lived here. She used to come in the workshop occasionally. I mean, she lost interest in it, but, you know, while the interest was there, she used to come in and, you know, have a mess about with things. And, you know, I dare say she probably learnt a bit as well. I like to think so. They're all out of the side. They're out of the hinges at the side, so where's the two screws? That went in the battery compartment. I think they're still there, to be honest. No, they're not. Fell out somewhere. Where did they fall out? They've got to be on the bench because nothing else fell on. Nothing fell onto the floor. So where's the 2 feet that went on the bottom? There they are. The 2 feet. Get myself another cup of tea or coffee in a minute, folks. We're coming to the end of this video. I think that other hinge needs to come off and be glued as well. It's a bit worse for wear, this. But sort the hinge out after. I've got to mix some epoxy up for it. I'm not reaching up there, but that other screw, it was pretty painful. I mean, taking these apart is no fucking fun. They're a bit of a pain in the arse to do these, but this one's now done. It's a shame about the aerial, but if I ever come across an aerial, I'll go back, I'll revisit it. Make sure that one's set aside tight. I mean, I might have to put something in between these to stop them vibrating with the base. Some foam or something. There we go. Right, let's get the speakers back up. I'll have a listen to it while I make a brew. And there we go. Shame about the aerial, but unfortunately, you know. Let's make sure which speaker wire we get where. This one is the left. These speaker wires are a bit stiff. A bit on the stiff side, to be honest, but I weren't changing them as well. That's the right speaker. Left speaker. Getting myself mixed up here, folks. Yeah. I hope we're all ready for Goldborn tomorrow. I certainly am. Pop that there for a minute. Get the other speaker, I mean. I mean, we're all set and done. I mean, this is, I mean, it is what it is, but, you know, when these were available, I think they still are in some places, but, you know, they certainly charge too much for them, in my opinion. I mean, I just think that for what they are, they're not worth the, certainly not worth the money that the places that were selling them were asking for them, you know. Where the fucking hell's the other wire? There it is. I mean, because they are cheap, I mean, they're not, you know, there's nothing high-end about them, or, you know, stress that against that. That one into the back of that, and I can actually hook that one on. But you know, I think for what they are, I mean, I suppose they're worth about 20 or 30 quid or something new, but I mean, some of these things were fucking nearly £100, I believe. I don't know exactly. Both speakers are on. Let's go back to the radio. Ooh, a bit of a crackle there, but... look at that, I'm really pleased with that volume control. Really pleased with how that turned out. I mean, that's as far back as it goes. I'd have liked that needle to go there, but it doesn't. It goes just past. But I'm happy with that. The base
gorgeous.
Off.
It's the Milano from Wren Kitchens. It comes with a massive 50% off. And that's plus the base off. Up to 20.
Years ago, has won the showpiece in back to back years. Among the other fancy.
Well, in himself, so we're very hopeful. But I mean, it's.
For that night, you know, paparazzi are all over the shop. You know what's coming. You are not a stupid man. You know. And yet you don't stand up and say. For Jamie O'Hara.
Yeah, yeah. No, I agree.
AM, long wave, and FM. Yeah, they're both working. Just trying the CD player. Play. I think this disc is a bit dodgy, folks. Yeah, look at that. Give it a clean. But I mean, there's something stuck on it there. That's it. Another wipe down. And it was done with a fucking burner, so it was probably fucking dodgy anyway. Let's try track 22 again. Let it read it. Try another disc. That's... Oh, here's one. Try this. That could be a dodgy disc. But let's try this one. This is the one with four tracks on it that I had in earlier. Let's try this. Be nice if the CD player wasn't faulty, because I don't want to go back into it. I've cleaned it, so I didn't lubricate the tracks all, so it could even be that. But I'm hoping. Let's just go for this. Play. Go for the next one. I think that's all right, because it even reads that a lot quicker than it did that burnt one. Reads it a lot faster. Yeah, a couple of seconds it's got it. It doesn't struggle either, so it must be that disc. But no problem at all with that. Right, folks, and I'm not going to show you going to doing this hinge. You know how to repair, so you know, you obviously know how to stick an hinge together. But just turn it all around if I can. There we go. Stand this speaker up. There we go. And that's the Spirit of St. Louis, or Louis if you prefer, radio CD player. And yeah, I'm pretty pleased with my lights. Yeah, pleased how they turned out. You can read, I mean, they don't necessarily have to be there. I mean, you can read the dial, but just makes it that bit easier, I think. And these LEDs are supposed to flash all the time when they're on. So there we go. That was the flight case, the NX 211 flight case stereo CD radio, as it calls it on there. And I mean to be honest with you, it's, you know, it's not top of the range, but like I say, it's, you know, it's, you know, it's made cheaply, but I think it looks good. You know, it's you know, not the sort of thing that you would say that, you know, if you were a serious radio listener, you wouldn't buy one of these. You wouldn't even give it a second look. But given that it's, you know, I think in summing up, I think the CD player's not bad. It's nice that it's got in and out auxiliary, so you can connect your cassette deck to it. And you can get stuff off this onto your cassette deck if you choose, or any other media that can, any other medium that can record. So it's nice to be able to get stuff out of it. Nice that you can do that. The radio's a big letdown. It's just a single chip radio. That's a bit of a letdown. The CD player, well, it's a CD player, isn't it? You know, CD players sound the same no matter how you look at it, and they do to me anyway. And I like to think I've got a very good ear. And, you know, but the CD player doesn't sound too bad. I've heard worse. I've heard better and all. I've got better. But, you know, yeah, I just think it'd make a nice ornament. Yeah, you know, which is a usable thing as well. And if somebody wants it more than I do, then if they're willing to purchase it rather cheaply, then yeah, I will sell it. But for the moment, I'm going to keep hold of it because I just think it's a nice thing to have around for a bit. And then when somebody takes a fancy to it, that's when I'll cease to own it. But I need to polish the catches and stuff, or try to anyway. I mean, I've seen 50s record players with better catches. You know, plus it'll run on batteries as well, if you so desired. It will run on... I think it's 8D cells it runs on. That's to give it what? That'd give it 12 volts, wouldn't it? 8D cells, 12 volts or something daft. But, you know, the main transformer in it didn't look too bad. It was a pretty substantial transformer that's in it. So, you know, the power supply was just a standard smoothing capacitor of value. I don't know, I didn't check. And they're basically probably just a half wave or a full wave bridge, which I didn't check. But the transformer was a fairly decent size. And I think this will polish up. You know, yeah. I think it'll, yeah. You know, the one good thing I will say about this item, they didn't put one of them slot loading cassettes in it, which are horrible, they'd never work. They didn't put one of them in it, thank God. You know, they just left you to choose whether you want to put a cassette into it yourself by giving you the sockets, the in and output. Like I say, I had the Ferguson on it. And I was listening to Patsy Cline on it earlier before I started yesterday, and it sounded absolutely nice. So I am, I will say impressed, but I'm pleased. You know, it'll all polish up, and I'll find somewhere in the front room to put it, or I might even have it as a bedroom radio. I could even have it in here on the work. I could even find somewhere in here to put it. Because then I've got an amplifier if I need it, haven't I? Because it's got the auxiliary, so I've got an amplifier if I need it. So, you know, the power button now works. Turn it all off. Takes a while for the LEDs to discharge. There we go. It stays on now. That was just a dry joint as well. I thought it was a bad power switch, but it's not. It was just a dry joint. Which luckily I was able to reflow it from the other side of the switch because of the way it was wired in. I just heated up the other side of the bar on the other side of the contact on the switch. And it reflowed the solder on the other side. And that sorted that out because I didn't want to take the amplifier out. Just to do one joint. Didn't want to do that. Anyway, folks, thanks for joining me. I'm going. And this is done. More to come later. Bye for now. And I hope to see some of you, like I say, I hope to see some of you at Goulburn tomorrow. Catch you later, folks. Bye.